It's time to durability test the Samsung Z Flip 6. I promised last year that if the Z Flip 5 survived my durability test, I would switch to it. I was fascinated with the futuristic form factor, so I moved my whole life over to this flippy phone and learned within 2 days that the folding smartphone life is not the life for me. I use my phone a lot, and the opening and folding motion drove me absolutely insane. Instead of just reaching for my phone and being able to use it instantly, I would have to pull it out of my pocket, figure out which direction was up, open it before I could use it, and then repeat the whole process to close it again. It sounds petty, but multiply that by 50 times a day, it was like that water droplet torture, just wearing me down little by little, eroding my sanity, and shaving little bits of my happiness off like a carrot headed to a salad. I absolutely could not handle it, so after about 30 days, I switched to the more rectangular Galaxy S24 Ultra. Flip phones are super cool and probably work great for someone who's not working from their phone, but yeah. Flip phones are not for me. Something that is for me, though, is Liquid IV, the number one powdered hydration brand in the USA and the sponsor of this video. You hear of batteries having something called an electrolyte, which is the space between the positive and negative terminals which allow the electrons to flow. And human bodies are the same way. We need electrolytes to regulate those chemical reactions that happen within our cells to give us energy. So if you're feeling under the weather or being tired a lot, being low on electrolytes could be one of the reasons. These scientifically formulated, flavored Liquid IV packets contain sodium, potassium, and essential B vitamins, 3 times the electrolytes of other sports drinks. So as I gear up for strenuous activities like running, going to the gym, or durability testing a Z Flip 6, I rip open a Liquid IV packet to make sure I have the hydration I need on a cellular level. These powders have no artificial colors or sweeteners and have several sugar-free options. Drinking water is great, but you need to find a way to get electrolytes, and Liquid IV Hydration Multipliers makes that easy. Get a 20% discount using my code with the link in the description, and thanks to Liquid IV for sponsoring this video.
The Flip 6 is incredibly and suspiciously similar to the Flip 5. At first glance, it has the same internal screen warnings as the previous generations, like don't press too hard, don't fold too hard, and don't take off the internal screen protector. But one thing I did notice fairly immediately is that the internal screen crease has been significantly reduced. It is still there, for sure, but from a reflection point of view, it is much more minimal than it used to be. There's barely even a squiggle from the reflection of my colored plastic pry tools. This could be the result of the new sheer thickening fluid, a flexible screen manufacturing process that Samsung has invented, or it could be that the older generation Flip 5 has been used for a month. It's hard to know for sure. Another small tweak is that instead of 3 earpiece slits, the newer Flip 6 has 4, and there's just a general more squared off design all around the outside edges. The inner screen of the Flip 5 being plastic honestly didn't bother me too much while using it. Which is good, since it looks like the new sheer thickening fluid screen on this new version also has the same level of scratch resistance. Scratches at a level 2, with deeper grooves at a level 3. And fingernails can still leave permanent marks on that top layer. The outer screen is a respectable 3.4 inches, and since it's made with Gorilla Glass Victus 2, we start seeing scratches at a level 6, with deeper grooves at a level 7. Samsung said they've enhanced the frame of the Flip 6. Instead of armor aluminum, it's now enhanced armor aluminum. The recessed power button and volume rocker are both metal, and the top of the Flip 6 has more aluminum, as well as the entire left side. We also find a metal SIM card tray. There's no expandable memory, but there is a rubber ring to help with that IP48 water resistance. Apparently, this thing can be submerged and still survive. Although I don't recommend testing fate with that activity. The bottom has a 25-watt USB-C port, and the central spine is also anodized aluminum, where even the logo can scratch off if damaged. As far as cameras go, we have a 12-megapixel wide-angle camera on the left, and a 50-megapixel normal camera towards the center, both protected with glass. There's a single LED flash next to the circular metal camera lens housings. Now, when Samsung said they are using a new sheer thickening fluid screen manufacturing process to cover the 1080p 6.7-inch 120Hz folding display, I was intrigued. Apparently, this STF process helps eliminate a few of the layers that make up the sandwich of the screen, helping it have that reduced crease in the center. The flexible sandwich lasts for about 14 seconds under the heat from my lighter before starting to melt. The pixels themselves look fine, but the outer screen is most definitely bubbling. Even with that bubbling and all of our previous abuses, the Galaxy Z Flip 6 is still functioning. I can't say for how much longer though, since obviously my durability tests are designed to find the structural limits of portable technology. And find the limits we must. We can't have people walking around with a smartphone that will collapse at the first sign of dust, now can we? The IP rating of 4.8 means that the Flip 6 is protected against small pieces of dust up to 1 millimeter in diameter. For my American audience, that's about the same size as an ant if you rip it in half first. The dust I'm applying now obviously is much smaller than what the Flip 6 is rated for, but besides a new subtle squeaky groaning sound, the hinge is not catching or grinding on that entering dust, which is good news. If it can survive all of this, the lint in your pocket should be just fine. But what about, you know, bending it backwards? I know you've thought about it. It would be so satisfying to see this thing snap in half like a Dorito Loco Nacho Cheese Taco. But alas, Samsung has again found some kind of wizardry that helps keep the Flip 6 intact. It flexes backwards quite a bit, but locks out, with no damage to the soft center screen, nor any damage to the hinge itself. The phone still clamps shut like the day it came out of the box, which was a few minutes ago. The Flip 6 survives my durability test. However, Samsung said that one of their improvements this year is an internal vapor chamber, and we would be doing them a massive disservice if we didn't go in and appreciate that chamber with our eyeballs. Taking off the internal plastic borders is a recipe for disaster, by the way. As soon as I try lifting up the flexible screen, the pixels fizzle out and become uniformly unpigmented. This is fine though, because now we can count the screen layers like some kind of robot autopsy. The first plastic layer is the one Samsung doesn't want removed, although they do provide one free screen protector professional replacement in the first year, with each subsequent replacement costing $20, which is fair. The next plastic layer to come up is a very much more permanent layer. This one might be the cured sheer thickening fluid layer, since right below it is the UTG, or ultra-thin glass. UTG is a super innovative material that Samsung has been using on the Google Pixel Fold as well as the Motorola Razr phones. Samsung is the top dog when it comes to flexible screens, which is why everyone else is using it. You can see the flexible glass reach its breaking point and shatter as I pull it away from the pixel layer. The glass shards are still clinging to a gluey laminate, and it's most definitely glass. If we're still friends after this, Samsung, I'd love to come see how these displays are manufactured. While the glass might not be on top of the flexible screen, it most definitely provides a solid underlayment for the upper plastics to sit on top of, and does a good job of protecting the pixels, since as you can see, once the AMOLED pixels are punctured, they go inky black and do not recover. Really cool stuff. We can pull the remnants of the screen away from the Flip 6 body, revealing the smoothly milled inner surface of the enhanced armor aluminum, as well as the silver of the redesigned hinge, which we can kinda see flexing here. We'll have to dive deeper into the hinge after we find that vapor chamber. The nice part is that even after losing 50% of its epidermis, the Flip 6 is still alive and doing well on the inside. I like a fighter. I'll warm up the back panel with my heat gun, but unfortunately, since the glass is so snugly recessed into the enhanced armor aluminum, we get some crackage. A little bit. It happens. We don't cry over spilt milk around these parts though, because accidents are part of life. Moving to the exterior screen, this one I would like to keep functional, there's a cool little trick that can only be done with this specific phone that I want to show you. Using the bezels to my advantage, I can slice around the edge of the glass where the adhesive holds it to the frame. And lucky for all of us, the screen comes away in one piece. The cool trick here is that normally we only get to see the optical image stabilization from the backside of the phones while they're turned off. But here, only with the Flip 6, can we physically disrupt the optical image stabilization while the phone is still on, and see how big of a physical shift the lens gets in order to keep a subject in focus. And thanks to that exterior screen, we can see the whole thing working live in real time. Thumbs up for that. Flipping the screen over, I can pop off a plastic gasket and unplug the screen ribbon like a little Lego. This thing looks super good inside. Samsung has always been great about making their internals even better looking than their externals. The silver protective plate has 8 Phillips head screws holding it over the motherboard, and the deeper we get, the better it looks. The extension ribbon for the main board looks like it has checkboxes for whatever market the phone is built for, like North America, Korea, Japan. I'll unplug the power button and proximity sensor, which is interestingly at the bottom of the exterior display. And I'll of course unplug the battery so we don't accidentally break anything. And amazingly, Samsung has again graced us with battery pull tabs. For better repairability and better recyclability, I'm a huge fan of these since lithium batteries are 95% recyclable. With the battery gone, even more amazinglier, we get our first glimpse of Samsung's absolutely massive Flip 6 vapor chamber. More like a vapor chamber of secrets, but this thing is huge. Moving over to the lower half of the Flip 6, there are 7 more Phillips head screws holding down the 15-watt wireless charger. We can see the coils of copper that snag electricity emanating from similar coils of copper on a wireless charging pad. The lower stereo speaker and black plastics can also be taken off at this point. The speaker does have a bunch of foam balls inside. These help the speaker sound more full, even though it's tiny. I'll finish unplugging the other side of the extension ribbon and the larger battery itself. And again, the whole battery can be lifted up and out of the frame by its glorious pull tabs. There's a total of 4,000 mAh. It's rather amazing how much Samsung has packed into such a little phone. The charging port board can come out, leaving behind a circular coin-style vibrator, and we see the waterproofing screen mesh over the loudspeaker opening and microphone hole. These are what help keep water out. The motherboard has a few screws of its own, and here's an accidental look at the sensor of the front-facing 10-megapixel selfie camera. That was a whoopsie. The SIM card tray, which does not include an SD card slot unfortunately, comes out. And after one more screw is removed near the dual cameras, the motherboard can come free, exposing the entirety of the Flip 6 vapor chamber. There's at least 10 pennies worth of copper in here. The 12-megapixel ultra-wide camera does not have optical image stabilization, but the 50-megapixel camera that we saw earlier most definitely does have OIS. Going back to that vapor chamber, the placement is interesting, since on most phones we see the vapor chamber touch both the processing location on the motherboard as well as the backside of the screen through a hole in the frame to better allow heat to escape out the thin AMOLED displays. But here on the Flip 6, the entirety of the upper half of the phone is milled aluminum, not really giving the heat anywhere to escape besides just conducting thermally through the aluminum itself and then out through the screen or the side rails, which is maybe why it needs to be so big. While we're here, we might as well scope out the hinge. Samsung is always tweaking things, and with that cover plate gone, we can see the gears and springs all working together to allow the Flip 6 to open and close and hold its position anywhere along its path. It's interesting though that even though previous generations of the Flip had a bristle cleaning system to help keep dust out, this time around the two halves of the phone are bristle free, even the center spine. The only thing keeping dust out is the super tight tolerances of the hinge mechanism itself, which might be why it's groaning a bit. As always, if you want to see the insides of your phone without the chaos of actually opening it up, might I suggest my X-ray skin collab with eBrand. We cover pretty much every popular phone with both teardown and X-ray skins. It's a true-to-life, accurate depiction of the internals, and protects better than the Secret Service. Link is down in the description, and thanks a ton for watching. I'll see you around.